हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज चैप्टर वन ऑफ क्लास एट साइंस फिजिकल साइंस. फोर्स, व्हाट इज फोर्स? ओके, फोर्स फोर्स इज अ स्ट्रेंथ और एनर्जी एक्सर्टेड और ब्रॉट टू बेयर और समथिंग दैट कॉजेस अ चेंज इन द मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके, पुश, आइडेंटिफाई पुश और पुल. ओके, व्हाट इज पुश एंड व्हाट इज पुल? Push is the force that moves an object away from something, and pull is the force that moves an object towards you. Okay, you have to just fill this table with the help of knowing that whether they are pulling or pushing by seeing this. Okay, digging borewell, that is they are pushing and pulling. They are just pulling the string up and then pushing down into the ground. So both you have to write. Sipping juice, you are pulling, okay? You are just pulling the juice from the glass. So, pull. Erasing blackboard, both. You are just pulling and pushing. You are taking the duster towards and away from you. So, both. And a magnet attracting nails. That is, you have to write a pull. Because a magnet attracting itself and exerting a pressure on the nails and pulling the nails towards it. Fruits falling from a tree. That is, gravitational force is exerted on the fruits and thus the mangoes are falling on the ground. So you have to write pull. And hoisting a flag. He is just pulling the rope so that he can hoist the flag. So you have to write here pull. Types of forces. So there are few different types of forces which are categorized into different thing, and different names have given for different forces experienced by different objects. So there are types of forces: contact forces and field forces. Contact forces are a force that is applied by object in contact with each other. Contact force acts on a point of direct contact between the two objects. This force can either be continuous as a continuous force or can be momentary in the form of an impulse. Contact force is governed by Newton's law. Contact force is responsible for most of the interactions we experience in our daily life. See, we brush daily. So, contact force is experienced by us in our daily life. We are just touching the toothpaste and just we are squeezing, and so the paste is coming out. So this is a contact between our and we are applying a force. That's why the paste is coming out. So it comes under contact force. Whereas this, they have placed a compass around the magnetic bar. And they are experiencing, they move, they show movement. So these are experiencing a non-contact force. They are not contacting with each other, but they are experiencing a force. This is called as field force or non-contact forces. And this can be described as, these occurs can be explained by the non-contact force is a force applied to an object by another body that is not in direct contact with it. It comes into play when objects do not have physical contact between them, or they force, and the force applied without any interactions. So force is applied without any interactions. And what all comes under contact forces and non-contact forces? So in non-contact forces, that is field forces, we have three types of forces, that is magnetic force, electrostatic force and a gravitational force. What is magnetic force? Magnetic force is an attraction or repulsion that arises between electrically charged particles because of their motion. So magnetic force are experienced by what? See here. He is rubbing the needles with a magnetic bar so that they experienced electrically charged particles and the motions and because of their motion it is can be we can just observe the what they are experience when we put these needles into a water bowl. And he has placed a different cork on the needles, that is red and a white bar, and by rubbing the magnetic bar on the needle, you should always just rub the magnet in only in one direction. Okay, that's then we can see a repulsion and a attraction between these. How we can see that? Because he has used this white and red cork. When he placed this into the water bowl, white are the light poles. So what happens? They will ripple, and when he placed in opposite direction, they will attract. So magnetic poles, we can say that they light poles attracts and light poles ripples and unlike poles attract each other. It is a basic force responsible for such effect as the action of electric motors and the attraction of magnets for iron. Okay, electrostatic force also the same. It experienced, see here. You just take a balloon and rub it with a paper and cut some pieces of papers and place them on the surface of the ground and just bring that balloon to towards these pieces of papers. So they will just attract with the balloon. So by observing this, we can say that yes, electrostatic forces are present between pieces of papers and the balloon. So it exerts a field pressure. Now, gravitational force. Here is the some activities. Okay, how they are doing. So now gravitational force. The force of attraction between masses in the universe, especially the attraction of the earth on masses for the bodies near its surface, is known as gravitational force. It acts upon the masses of the bodies. It is universal. Okay, it attracts all the particle, all the objects which possess mass. So it magnetic force, here you have the correct. By observing this experiment, one can say gravitational force works even the objects are not in contact. So this is an example of field force. Now, explanation of force acting at distance, concept of fields, how we can visualize. See, electric charges are too small, we can't visualize. And as well as gravitational force also, we can't visualize. But whereas we can hold the magnet and we can place some iron particles or iron ores or powdery iron material onto the paper sheet, and we can place a magnet and we can just sprinkle all the iron mixture or iron powder so that we can observe the magnetic field in this way. So we can, with this, by seeing this picture, and this is, we have to mark with a pencil how they are arranged around the magnetic bars, which gives the idea or a conclusion that yes, they possess a magnetic field of force, magnetic field which exert force on the iron particles. So contact forces, contact forces, that is muscular force. Muscular force is that force is created through the use of muscles. By what? By the use of muscles. It happens as a result of muscle contraction that pulls to create movement. Whatever the movement we do, if we smile, that is the movement of the muscles. So all the movements comes under muscular force. You have to write certain movements here for muscular force. Force of friction. What is force of friction? It is generated by two surfaces that contact and slide against each other. These forces are mainly affected by the surface texture and amount of force impelling them together. The angle and position of the object affects the amount of friction force. The force of friction is generated by what? By the two surfaces that contact and slide against each other. Like if we are cycling, so there is a friction of force between tire and the road. So that is sliding against each other. The force are mainly affected by the surface texture. What are the factors which affect the force of friction? The texture. Texture, whether it is a smooth or rough or a carpet area, anything. So that is affected by, that affects the force of friction. And the amount of force impelling them together. And the amount of force. And how much force we are putting while we say cycling, while we are pedaling. How much force we are putting. If we, it is a smooth surface area, we just put less amount of force. And if it is a rough area or it is a high elevated area or we have so many of friction, like all the stones or a rough area or a area with grease and all, so we put more effort. So that that is also affect the force of friction. The angle and position of the object affects the amount of friction force, and the position also affects the how in which position we are. Okay, position means whether we are in a high elevated area or we are going against the gravitational force or towards the gravitational force. Like that, from top to bottom, or the direction, in which direction, that also affects the force of friction. Actually, what is friction? Friction is the resistance. What is friction? It is a resistance to motion of one object moving relative to another. So how it resist? Resistant means it resists the movements. If we put our leg onto the ground, it won't we won't slip because we have friction with our foot and the ground. So it is providing a resistance to the motion of if we want to walk slowly, we can walk slowly. If we want to run, we can run. So it is providing a certain amount of resistance to motion of one object moving relative to another. It is not a fundamental force like gravity or electromagnetic. So it is not a fundamental force like gravity or which possesses of equal amount of force, or which just if we use a magnetic bars of like a bigger magnetic bars. So it have a more magnetic field. And if we use electromagnetic charges, if we use a high amount of electricity, it has more charges. But whereas it comes in with the gravitational force or the frictional force, it is not a fundamental force. Instead, scientists believe it is the result of the electromagnetic attraction between charged particles into touching surfaces. Okay. What is a normal force? Here is a normal force. We can see here a table and a book upon it. Normal force is the component of a contact force. See, here we can say it is a contact force because it is contacting with a table. That is perpendicular to the surface that an object contracts. Okay, but whereas it is experiencing a gravitational force, we said that gravitational force is not a non-contact force, but it is experiencing a gravitational force. So all the objects present in the universe will experience a normal force that is perpendicular to the surface that on objects contacts. It is contacting with what? with an object. If an object is present in between gravitational force and the book, so it is acting as an object and it is contacting with it, and it is creating a zero gravity, and it is creating a zero force on the book, and it keeps the book stable here. For example, surface of a floor or a table that present on the object for and that that prevents object from falling. It won't fall down. Okay, and tension. Tension. It is also a type of force, but in this we can say that it is experienced. We can say it's a force along the length of a medium, especially a force carried by a flexible medium. That is, it is experienced. All force is experienced by along the medium, all over the medium to this. Such as a rope or a cable. Tension can be defined as action-reaction pair of force acting at each end of the said element. Like here, we are with a rope, they have attached amount of mass, let's say a weight, which is experiencing a gravitational pull towards down. So they all along the medium, it is experiencing a force, which is called as tension. And this we can conclude with the help of this. We can do an experiment on this by placing a spring and a scale for measuring the elevation of the spring, and by changing the weight of the weight by which we can say that how much spring is elevated, how much gravitational force is experienced by the spring with the increase in the weight. So we can just table here and we can write the changes and the string how much it expands and at what amount of change in the weight. And next is the net force. Net force is a single force that replaces the effect of the original force on the particle motion. It gives the particle as same acceleration as all those actual force together, as described by the Newton's second law of motion. Okay, net force. This I have written answers. I will explain there all these things. Let me tell you about pressure. It is also an important force. It's an amount of force on the surface per unit area. You just remember that it's a amount of force on a surface per unit area.